Each morning, 6 days a week, 1,200 men and women come to work to raise Tower One into the skyline. They face a mammoth task. Before the 10th anniversary of September 11th, they must band together to double Tower One's height and reach 1,000 feet. As the cold weather begins to set in, it's up to the iron workers to keep the tower climbing into the sky.
We're rebuilding America. Right here, you know, we're showing that we can do it. We'll get it done.
When connecting each new steel floor, Tommy, Mike, and the other iron workers rely on their skill and experience to keep their balance.
Yeah, come to me.
It's one of the most dangerous places to work, absolutely bar none. Just the heights that we're working at. And the only thing that's keeping you inside the building is a 3/8 safety cable. You could fall through these cables and everything else, even just being on the deck.
Carlos!
We have to have steel come at us while we're standing on these, on headers, and, you know, that are 6 inches, 8 inches wide.
You know what? You're too big for this iron.
Ironworking is a legacy profession, going back generations in each family. Mohawk Indian Peter Jay has been ironworking almost his entire life.
Right now, my plan is, after this, I'm done. I'm going home. We spend the next 30 winters taking care of my wife. I'm trying to pass down the throne, you know, to pass down that gavel to them boys, men. They're men, you know? Like Tommy, I've known Tommy since Tommy was a little kid, you know? I worked with his grandfather. Mike O'Reilly, Tommy Hickey, they're good men, you know?
This is my father's first job, World Trade Center, Tower One. I remember my father giving me a belt when I was about his age in the basement. So that's yours when you grow up. And I'm the only one, I got two other brothers, I'm the only one who got into the business. And my father's kind of proud of that because he wanted to keep the name going.
Mike's family history also ties him to this site.
My father was a connector on 7 World Trade Center. My father got hurt on this building, putting it up. It was a Friday morning. I was 11 years old. He decides that he was gonna slide down his column like we do every day. He finds himself fallen, and he fell 2 stories. He fell onto steel that was shook out, and he broke his back in a few places. He was paralyzed from his waist down. But first thing he said when he fell was, "Can I have a cigarette? And let's get back to work." I mean, that's the kind of guy this man was. He was something else. He's my dad, you know. On 9/11, everything changed. When this building fell down, it took something like out of me, because my father got hurt on this building putting it up.
Coming over, yeah?
And as long as this building was here, I knew that he got hurt for something. And then this building fell down, and it was all for nothing. And I approached him, I asked him if I can, you know, go iron work. And he needed a little more convincing, and I did it, and he got me in.